You're watching Yellowstone In Depth.
Sometimes Son of Green Dragon is actually spritzing out onto the walkway. The new feature, the mud pot, that bubbled up sometime yesterday morning or the night before, occasionally spritzing out a little mud, some of it right in the walkway. Some of it appears almost like a lava flow of mud. By the thudding sound it's making, it sounds like it may even be hollow underneath the walkway. This area out there where all the steam is coming up is called hydrophane. Lately it's really heating up over there. In fact, all these brown pine trees have been killed in the last few months. Jetsam Pool, normally opalescent blue, in the last few days has turned this milky green, heating up. The algae bacteria mat has also been cooked and is now floating around the perimeter of the pool. Pearl is now in full steam phase. I watched this progress from a full pool to blue milky water in a matter of less than 8 hours. The water receded, splashed, and then now all it's pumping is steam. Hardly any runoff at Steamboat compared to 2 days ago, but both dens seem to be extremely active all day today. Cistern appears to be superheated, much more intense boiling type activity since the last 2 days, since this event started. Vixen Geyser major eruption's been going over 12 minutes prior to our arrival. Sometimes heights are going as high as 40 feet. Prior to 2 days ago, it was going sometimes hours between eruptions. Over the last 36 hours, it's increased to the point where it's every few minutes, sometimes eruption lasting 45 minutes to an hour. New feature near Pork Chop, just south of Pork Chop, that just broke through, had been warm cooking for several months. Now there's a tremendous amount of steam. This whole frying pan area out here, this is really drying up where the brown was, extended out into the white considerably. These little mud spritzes here were small bubbling geysers about 1 foot high all spring, and then yesterday they began geysing mud. Green Dragon Spring, intense geysing activity, very, very muddy water. Much more active than average. On the left side of the cave mouth can sometimes go 2 meters high, over 6 feet high. Colloidal pool, normally clear, bluish, except after a rainstorm when mud gets washed in. Now is very murky, very active churning. We have had no rainfall in the last several days, so this is something going on underground causing this activity.